Now let's implement the color changing functionality. That is, when the user clicks any of these color boxes, that color should be given to the current element. So when the user selects a color while working on a note, that particular note's color should be changed. And if the color is clicked after creating a new note, that newly added note should get the selected color. So we should decide which note's color should be changed. So let's implement that here. Let me create a variable called current element. Okay. And let me set its value to be an empty string. So initially the current element is empty. Now here what we can do, if we want to change the color of the last created element, we can set current element to this ID, sticky ID. So here before incrementing the value, we can set current element to be sticky plus ID, which means sticky, the ID can be 1, 2, 3 like that. So before incrementing the value of ID, we are specifying current element is sticky ID, which means if the user clicks any of the color box after creating a new note, that current element will get the chosen color. So how we can implement that? When the user clicks on this box, so we can write here dollar dot box dot click. Let me write function. Okay. And within this, we need to write the code. Let us make a simple check, like if current element is not equal to empty. The current element is empty means there is no current element of which color is to be changed. So we are checking current element is not equal to empty. In that case, what we should do, we should get the currently selected color, and that color should be given to the current element. So how we can get the currently selected element? If we specify, let me create another variable where color equals dollar this dot attr of class. This will give two class names, right? Dollar this dot attr means whichever box is clicked, but it is having two class names, green box, pink box, peach box, like that. So we need to get the very first class name. So we can split this array using space, as there is a space here, because this color will now get green box, pink box, like that, with a space in between. So if we split it using a single space and get the first item, then it will be the color of the currently clicked box. So that color should be given to the current element. Now let's add this color as a class of the sticky note, that is the current element. So how we can access the current element? We can specify dollar hash, then we need to specify the current element so that the item with this ID will be selected. The current element is actually the ID of the sticky notes. So when we specify hash current element, that element will be selected. Then we can specify add class, then the color, so that this color will be added as the class name and that color will be given to the item. Now let's check whether we are getting the output or not. Let me save. Let me create a new note. It is green in color. Why? Because by default here we have specified green as the color. If we specify pink or peach here, that will be the color of the notes by default. Okay. Now suppose I click pink. Yes, that color is given. Peach, yes. Blue, yes. Suppose I click green again. See, that color is not changed. Why? When we specify add class here, each time the class is getting added. So the item will be having a number of colors as its class name. So when it is having many class names, it is not getting affected. So what we can do is that before adding class, we can remove the existing class and then add it. So what we need to do, let's specify here. Let me select this and specify remove class, so that all its existing class names will be removed. And later here, we have to specify sticky as well, because when we specify remove class, all the class names including sticky will be removed. So as we need the sticky class name for styling, we have to specify add class sticky, then the color. Now let's see, save. Let me refresh, new note, it is green. Peach, yes, pink, yes, green, yes, blue, yes, pink, peach, green. You can change the color as many times you want. But before this implementation, that is, when we just specified add class and the color, it was not getting changed after 3 or 4 color changes because it was repeatedly getting the same color again and again. So what we have done here is that we have used the remove class method so that all the class names will be removed of the current element, and then we are adding the sticky class and also the currently selected color. So here we are able to change the color of the currently created item, right? Now suppose I click this element and I want to change the color of this one to blue. It is not getting done. Why? Because here we have specified the current element as a currently created node. That is why, suppose I refresh, let me create 3 nodes or 4 nodes, and if I change the colors, the last item's color is getting changed. Suppose I click this one and try to change the color, it is not getting changed. In fact, the color of the last item is getting changed. So what we need to do here, we need to update the current element to this one once this item is clicked. So let's do that. So we need to update this current element on the click of the sticky notes as well. But we cannot implement it on click of sticky. Why? Because this is a dynamically created element. So if you remember, we have already discussed in one of the previous projects that event delegation needs to be done in case of dynamically added elements, right? Instead of writing sticky.click, we need to delegate it to the parent, which is the container. So here let me write $#container.on. Then what are the parameters we need to pass? First one is the event, which is click. Then second one is the element on which we need to implement the event, that is dot sticky. And then we need to write the function as the third one. So function, and here we need to write the code. So what we need to do, we need to update the current element to the currently clicked sticky notes, right? Hope you understand this. Instead of writing sticky.click directly, why we are writing like this? Because these elements with class name sticky are dynamically created. That is, when we specify sticky.click, it will be applied to only existing elements. So in this case, we need to delegate the event. So it is event delegation or event bubbling. So here we need to write #container, which is the parent. And it will take care of this event on its child element with class name sticky. Now how we can get the current element? We can specify current element equals. How we can get the value? We can specify $this.attr of ID. So let me refresh here. Let me click new note, new note, new note. One more. And let me click pink. See, its color is changed. Now let me click this element. Let me click blue. See, its color is getting changed. Orange, its color is getting changed. Let me click this and click blue. See, color is changed. Click this, green, its color is changed. Let me click a new note and let me now click blue. The last one is changed. This one, pink, its color is changed. So the color changing functionality is now working fine as we have updated the current element in both cases, that is initially when a new node is created and also when an existing node is clicked. That is why we are able to change the color of new elements as well as currently clicked element. Okay, so here I'm changing it to pink. Next, what we need to do, actually these elements are draggable, but now the users will not understand that these elements are draggable. So let's change the style of the cursor in case of sticky. So here for sticky, let me specify cursor to be all scroll type. Now let's see, let me refresh, let me click. See, this is the style of the cursor now. So now we are done with the color changing functionality. Next, we need to implement some more functionalities which we will do in the next lecture.